been kicked in after him.
Yeah, that's right. She was his niece. King William's niece was Queen Victoria in 1837, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right, Queen Victoria.
Yeah, and when they saw a third funeral, they took them all out and they got on a piece. They celebrated one on a piece in Napier. Yeah. And then they went down and I wanted to see the Queen take the badge off
it. Yeah, so those were the people who were killing the people of the land.
Yeah, yeah.
At that time. That's right. They were killing them. The people who are originally from there, Parapara being one, that name is goes with Manukau right through the country. It's all over the place. It's on Stewart Island. That's where they came from, and Chatham Islands and Stewart Island, South Island, Motueka. That's all Manukau Parapara's all the way through there, and right through the North Island as well. Parapara's and Manukau's are all the way down.
Yeah.
Those two names was the oldest names that I've got on the Manukau history. And that's what the British got. The British got a hold of that. And then they put the Manukau Land Company together in Scotland. In Glasgow. Then they made the Te Rā Waikato Wharehere Manukau was over there with Hongi Hika before 1830. They were there, but Hongi was there to learn combat and how to conquer the Maoris, and from Ngāpuhi, and the Waikato chief was this Manukau guy was learning all the land titles and transfers and mortgages. But back then, so they used him to make their blueprint here of New Zealand before they took it right through all the other indigenous countries in the world. The same title went right through the world under King William. Then when Queen Victoria came along, that's when all the corruption started with the Rothschilds took over. The Rothschilds married into Queen Victoria, made kids. Those are the cabals that are running the place now. And those are the ones I'm going to knock out with this title. Because they all used the same one king to get all their mortgages, because King William III, before King William IV, put the Bank of England together and pound note. That's why I'm using the pound note from that king. And then William took it around the world with our flag.
Yeah,
so that's that part. But it's the church that's holding the key, because they started the parliament off.
Yeah, the church.
The church did.
That was through the Queen.
Yeah, through the Queen. That's what started it off here in 1837. That's when it started in Rangitukia. You can see in Te Araroa, 1837 was when they set up in Te Araroa, in Rangitukia, and Hiruharama up that way, Whakawhitira.
Yeah, I don't think that all, but the Wanoa didn't come in until about the 50s.
Yeah, so that I'm talking about the ministers. The ministers of the church was the Kaa and the Wanoa. Those were the two. I got the Whakapapa off looking through all the treaty claims today, and so I've got a fair measure of who's who and where who came from, because those names like Hikurangi comes from Chatham Islands. That's UFO there. That's where they. Yeah, that's where the UFO is. That's what Moi Manuka was talking to me about. But they were all laughing at him. I'm the only one that was listening to what he was saying, that in the Kaipara, the same where they came into, that the UFOs in the Kaipara. But I didn't go down that track of looking further into that area. I just stood on the, because being real estate, I was only concerned with the commerce of where the money was being made, right? So the church kept all the records of all the history of who was giving the history to them. But when you have a look at all the cross claims or the treaty claims, I can pick it up straight off of who's Tupuna you're talking about. Because she's got the ones you gave me They are there, on, and it's right that Raru came before Whātanga. But there were some other tūpunas in the Chathams that I've picked up on the names. There's Te One is in the Chathams, Tūranga is in the Chathams, Manukau is in the Chathams, and there's a few other names there, but I've got them on that document. I'll email to you because it's on Facebook. And I'm going to print it out tomorrow and put it on YouTube. I'm going to explain it. That's all it's around. It's around Toi Kairaka. The Toi Kairaka and the old map, it's got Hikurangi and it's got Aoraki on the other mountain next to it. You see? So, Aoraki. And Aoraki is the same name as Aorangi. The Rangi comes from what's that place? There's Rekuhu. Chatham Islands, its name is Rekuhu. Okay? Rekuhu. That's what Chatham Islands' real name is. Rekuhu. Rekuhu. And so all the original names here have come from there. I'm claiming all the names over here came from there. And they came with those Moriori here before anybody came. The Moriori Tuhoe Miss people. The Miss, they're the same ones. That fellow we call to Jim, he's in both places. You see why the Maori Land Court put him on the Haha block and on the Tuhoe block in Kuterere Marae area, just between Opotiki and Tanetu. Kuterere. Now that's the same Oneone. That's the same Oneone. On Chatham Islands, it's got on Chatham Islands, it's got Te One. Yeah, same one. But you can see. Yeah, so that's the one I've checked up. I've double checked across everybody else's treaty claims and of stuff I've picked up from Reku, East Island. I've picked up more from there than here. Because what happened was Tainui and Ngāpui killed them all and took their history to Maori. Right? Yeah, I know. Yeah, so this is what they're writing in the history on the treaty claims. Some are saying one thing, others are saying another. So I've just gone straight across the board. I'm only claiming the name Manukau, the name Hikurangi, the Rangi, the name with the Rangi in it, came from over there to here. It didn't go from here to there. Just the Maori did that from here to there. Maori is not a real word. That's the Crown made that up. They made the history for their commerce, for the New Zealand and New South Wales government's commerce. No, they're nothing. There's no such thing as, when you look at all the history records, there's no name called Maori anywhere on the Manukau's history in the British. It only got invented in 1945, the war for Maori Land Court, to make Maori titles and put everybody in a box. They created the Maori, the concept of today, today's world, is that everybody thinks they're Maori. Until now, I'm just saying to these chiefs, drop the Maori and go after the Moai, and it'll stuff them. I mean the government, the Crown. It'll stuff the Crown, because that's their book, history. So all I'm saying is it was a native war, nothing to do with British, until they came along with their people and made native look the same. Right? They made them all the same, put them in the same box, and that's why today, otherwise, very different. I've learned a lot on being up at Waitangi, on Tiki Marae, for the last 20 years. I've heard, and I've heard them talk, Arawa will never talk straight face to Tainui, will never talk straight face to Ngāpui, will never say, talk straight face to Ngati Porou. They never. Look at Sue Nicola. They made her sit down. Yeah, that's right. It's confused the whole thing. That's why the Ngāpui sang Sue off the, when she was there when the Governor General came in. She was getting her normal thing, and then they shut her down.
Yeah,
but that still hasn't changed over these years I've been with them. That's why I pulled off and went my own way. And now it's starting to, on Facebook, my stuff is getting more accepted now.
People are thinking, I see some of them
commenting. The thing is, it belongs to them. Whatever I say belongs to them, because they'll know they've been duped by some people that the Crown put there out of our people. They've picked who they want and stuck them there for them. So I'll be making a video for that page where I've just put, Dion, on that waka. I've cut the trailer out and just put the front end of the waka there onto that page where that map is. I've stuck it there so that you can see it. You can see it and then put some things in there. Why the 1837, the 1831, and so on. But it was your family's reverends and Reverend Wanoa's that actually went along with the St. Mary's Church. And that's why that Rahui Marae, even its name Rahui, it puts a ban on everything that's wrong meaning. But that's full of my own Wanoa family in Tikitiki. It's got all the whole thing there. Because what happens is Mataru Wanoa, my grandfather, built and redid all the marais up that has been there that they used at the time, and that's the only place that's got 1831 on that map. There's no other. You can see who came and when by the years that, like, 1837 is Whakawhitira, so they've got that name sticking out a mile up in Hiruharama way. And they've got Rangitukia sticking out the biggest mile at 1831. It's clearly marked on that old map. I pulled the map out and I said, right, there's the answer right there. That's proof. That's what you call fact evidence, right?
That's why they only took you a lot more than one place.
No, it's Tikitiki. I'm going on. It says when they settled with the church, when the church started writing the stories, right?
Yeah.
The church stories are more accurate than the tribunal and those professors that put the histories together, like Gudgeon and all the rest of them. They took it from someone that was prepared to give them what those tūpunas would give them, but not all the history was accurate, because the church has more accurate figures of who was at the church and who was saying what, and the names of the people. I only got on the names of the people at that time, you see? So that's title. That tells me that's sovereign. Meaning I was here, there. I was here, Kaa was there, Wanoa was there. That's it. I don't worry about anybody else's name. I'm just talking for our name, right? Those two names feature in the St. Mary's Anglican Church and in Tikitiki. So Tikitiki, they landed at that time, the people of us, like the Wanoa at that time, landed from the islands, landed on that beach at Rangitukia. That's why I've got a big arrow going to Te Araroa. But in Te Araroa, you think it would have 1831? No, it's got 1837. You see? Because there was people jumping all over the place there. And it became colonial in 1837. That's when King William died, and that's when Queen Victoria took over as the Queen of England. Right?
Oh, that's when he died.
Yeah, he died then. That's when everything... That's why I'm matching it up with the flag. Right? The flag was reigning monarch for us and our flag right up to 1837. And no one can talk before that. We can. You can talk. I can talk. Because the two ministers are from England. And we go on England title. Not Australia, New Zealand title. That's the end of it. See? You get the picture? You don't have to worry about whakapapa of anybody's, you just worry about the church. Because it says there clearly, it says, the judge, the court's judge, prefers Mana Whenua. That's Mana Whenua. The one that says, I was here, I saw you come in, not 1837. See? So your family was here the same time period that we need to worry about. We don't have to worry about 1840 or anybody after that, or anybody from 1831 forward. Because we're saying, we were here, where's your proof? Right?
Yeah.
And the rest is history. Because they can tell them their stories about anything, but you won't get the land back because it's got mortgages on it. It's got all these British things all over it. It's got Australian things all over it. So what I'm doing is seizing all the Australian things off it. You get the picture?
Yeah.
That's how it works.
Yep.
That in real estate, that's how they accumulate properties worth and value and land and all the rest of it. They put their instrument on it. So that's why I've got all those instruments, the power note ready to go and stick on them. So from now to the 14th, right? From now to the 14th, I've only got that time to make a video for each of about 12 people who I'm pulling into the court in when we're going to Parihaka. And those 12 people has to refute the affidavit I'm accusing them of being pirates, because that's what I flagged for, pirates. And 21-day notice from the 14th to the 28th, from a Friday, the 14th, to the 28th of April, is 28 days, right? 21 days. And then I take that to Parihaka on the 1st. I'll go on the 30th. And then the native hearings, I'm going to address over there and open it up. I know the old guy there, and they'll already know this before I get there, that when I go there, I open the court up to put this hearing straight in, and invite them over to Rangitukia, to that land block. We're going to take that land block because it's ready to go. It's ready to go. We only need to do one to crack the whole native right through the world. Because that's the same St. Mary's Church of England that's gone through the world, on the native lands, right through the world, with the Queen Victoria, and now Queen Elizabeth has corrupted the whole Admiralty system, the flag. They've corrupted our flag, and it's still a contract. Still a contract. It's a private contract. Nobody's business. So nobody can tell us what to do. Between your ancestors in Britain and my ancestors from Rapa Nui or Raiatea Island and the rest coming from anywhere else, it's immaterial. Because we have the overriding fact evidence that no one can refute or rebut.
Yeah.
They can't rebut what is on that map.
Yeah.
It's got all the years all over it between in our area anyway. Ngati Porou.
Ah.
Yeah, in the area of Ngati Porou. Not the whole area. Only the area from Rangitukia to up the back of Whakaniangi. Only in the Marangaro area, right? Because the marae, our own marae, used to be called Marangaro marae. It's called Awatere marae. They changed it. The same Maori IWI Maori crown, they changed it for their sake of their documents, to make their documents look real, right?
Yep.
And they changed the marae, used to be called Rongomai Tapoe in Te Araroa. That's its original name. That comes from Chatham Islands. That name came from Chatham Islands straight to there. So that's the paraparas for you there. You see?
Yeah,
paraparas. That's an old name. And you've got the haingas and the wānoas are one of the same. And the puhas.
Yep. No, of, puhas.
Huh? Yeah. Puhas, yeah. Just, there's only a few names, not all of them. There's only a few people. You got parangātais and ngātais. I think the parangātai is in with us. The ngātai is more ngāpuhi.
Taurang.
Taurang, okay.
Rangitukia,
that's St. John's,
but that
was
named
John
Onikate. Oh,
I see. The one
in
Rangitukia. Oh, that's where they come from.
Yeah,
you'd know that. So it's safe to say that, what's his name? Kaa. This fellow Kaa. He's a Reverend Kaa. Huh? No, Albert Kaa. Hang on. There's some before that. This is 1831, mate. Your history goes right back. Where the reverends have gone right through. Hang on, I'll try and find it. I'll send it over to you. But I got the name. There's a few reverends. There's a few of them. Before that. I got the blooming thing. Gosh, I put it somewhere. I'm just trying to see if I can see it. Rangitukia, Tikitiki. I'll send it to you. I've put it all on Facebook. I've stuck this all on Facebook to show everybody who the hell, and I put a meter there. I put a bullshit meter there. And I says, look, it's going off the scale. those people who are, because their ancestors changed everything and they put them crook. But you're safe because this Toroa, Reverend Toroa Wanoa, was around about the same time as the other Kaa. I just can't think of that. Gosh, I wrote the paper. Yeah. I've just got my, just hold on. I've got a lot of flesh. Right in here and there.
You've got stuff everywhere.
Yeah, no, I've been flat out today. I'm going for it now, and Jamie's following me behind me, and she really picks up quick. You've got about five car reverends from 1831. Yeah, 1831. So, 1831. Yeah, when the thing started up, when the church started up, that was the first. It says here that was the first place they started off in New Zealand. At Tikitiki, more so. Now I'll send it to you. I'll find it because I'm just trying to look for the bloody. But I've gone and shifted everything around. Ngati Porou maps written. Yeah. So it looks like this. It'll be a clear run to Parihaka. And they will accept the history of what I'm saying, because when I put everything together from us at Rangitukia and the Manukau's stuff from Kaipara Apa from Taranaki and Jim going across there, Jim fixes them all up. At Waitangi, they listen to him because he says he's the tuakana of them all in Matatia, right? I can't mistake what he's saying at from Tuhoi, and so he covers all of that one shot, and then on the haha there, why would they put him on the land block there and up in Tuhoi? You see, that part adds up. Though he's falls short of knowing enough about where the Manukau was fitted, because that was a carefully guarded secret. That's a banker's secret, the Manukau part, because they're the ones that actually helped to sell the land. And then it was Pōmare that actually sold the land, but he didn't know who had put the native title together until I've blown it all apart now. Because this is one thing that Mohi Manuka would never tell anybody. He only told me. You see? He didn't even tell his family or his son in Manuka. He didn't tell anybody in all his Freemason stuff. I've got them here. I've got all the title here for this country to take it out any time I wanted to. It was just that I wanted to make sure everybody was on the same page before I made a move. And that's why it's taken me so long, because I wanted to make sure everybody was on the same support. To put all their things aside, don't say one is better than the other. Because in we've got one beast that we've got to get out of the road, and that's the beast in Wellington and Waitangi. That's masking us behind this Maori thing, that it's the Queen's people are Maori, and it's being fashioned so that the Queen can do what she likes with the Maori. Right? That's why they got Mata Parai in Britain now as an ambassador to New Zealand as a Maori, because he looks like one. Right?
Yeah.
But he's not a real Mata Parai. He's an Andrews, St. Andrews Church, an Andrews.
Yeah.
That's his real sir. So he's everything is whanau this and whanau that. That's why it's all up to hell. People stealing other people's names. That's what they're doing. That's how they manage to get above the real. The Mana Whenua is the sovereign one, the one that actually was there first before anybody else. The Tangata Whenua are the ones that are controlling what happens to the land, being the crown.
Yeah.
The Crown is acting tongue of family. Right? That's what. Yeah. That's how it works. But if you talk, they don't like anybody talking about Mana Whenua.
Yeah.
Because they say, how can you prove it? No, you have to swear black and blue that you're right.
Yeah.
You should be telling the Crown to swear black and blue who they are.
Yeah.
Not you having to give them all your whakapapa and your secrets, and then they take it. And then they use it against you. That's what happens. You see? Yeah, it is. It is. But that's like Ngati Porou. Porou-rangi and Porou-rangi and Ngātau. Ngātau's got, they got all the money at their hands for the Crown. They got the whole South Island. It's not even theirs. Nah, because that's what Moi said. He just got on a boat and went across there and said, the Crown said it belongs to him. And then next minute, they've got it. And I'm saying, hang on, that's not the right people. Ma Moi is the ones that was there before them. You see?
So, yeah,
that's the problem with the Ngātau. Yeah, the Ngātau is the same bullshit as that's what I said, the meter went off the clock. I put the meter there just so they can see the meter moving and going, and then the handle flies off. I said, this is how much bullshit there is. It's the Crown doing it. And the Ngati Porou, that fellow selling Porata, you know, his real name is Pratt. Pratt and Whitney is aircraft engines. Pratt and Whitney is the other one. Pratt, they're the family with all the money.
So
all you have to do is you say, where does Porata come from? They can't tell you. They can't tell you because there's nothing, just made it up. That's what I'm saying. It didn't matter in commerce so long as someone believed it and they accepted it. When you go into their court and you say, well, that's all we're going to settle you with, and you say, okay, I'll take this much, that means that's all over. And you accept that the bullshit story is the right one. But when you go into the church and use the church, different story.
Yeah,
that's what I'm doing. See? And the British will like it more because it's looking more better for them, because they're in trouble too. The Muslims have taken them over because they've gone and stolen the Muslims' country. Now the Muslims are there killing them. And so the Queen doesn't care because she's sitting in a bunker in Brussels. She's more or less left Britain, or just sitting there ready for an escape. But she's got all the money. That's what I'm saying. That's what I've been doing all along. I'm saying in front of everybody on Facebook, I'm going to hang her when I get there. See, you've got to talk like that because they don't care. The Rothschilds, they just assassinate anybody that doesn't listen to them. That's how they work. They've stolen them. When you steal something, you don't want anybody to get it off it.
No, that's right.
See? So that's what a pirate does. That's what our flag is for, pirates, who steal. But our people, our Maori people, didn't know they was too soft-hearted. And says, no, better not go down that track. We better not take them off. And I'm the opposite. I say, right, time for a scrap, you know? You're right or wrong. One of us is a crook. And the more you say that, the more they'll say, well, he's forcing you to do something. If you don't do it, he says he's going to take it. See? So the video is better as evidence because it's my lips moving. It's me saying something about somebody else, and it's up to that person to make a video, and it's only on a mobile. They can just make a video on a mobile in 3 minutes, then upload it to Facebook, and that's like a Twitter. A Twitter. Obama or Trump, they put a tweet straight out, and it does something to them. You see, just a few words, a few words, and it changes the whole scene. You see? So when I put a video out, that's why I put a lot of videos out now, because there's too many videos for anybody to try and get out of. From Cook Street, you see? So now I can see Cook Street crumbling over when I get this all sorted out with Parihaka. But Te Huirangi Waikere Puru, he's the old guy over there. I've been with him for a long time on the same issues. And they've been fighting against the system for Parihaka and still get nothing. So I'm going down there to tell them, right, this is how you do it. Follow me. Yeah, follow me. Come down to East Coast. We'll do that one and I'll come back and get your one. See? I've got to make sure we're ready for any changes. Because it just looks a bit too real now. And suddenly Jamie's woken up to a lot of things in one day. That's today. I'm glad you rang, because I'll flip this thing over to you, and you'll see the ministers. You'll see that I put it there. I've just got to go and get the PDF file on the Tikitiki, the church. And that's our key. That's the key to unlocking everything. Yeah, just those ministers, Kaa and the Wanoa. They went together all the way through. I was told, I think one time I'm supposed to be a minister. Yeah, I'm supposed to be following in the footsteps of the ministers. Yeah, but... No, I don't think I was cut out to be that. I'll try and see if I can see this part. I didn't write it. But I'll put it in an email anyway, and you can see, but that's where I'm at. I've got more days to get till. I've got plenty of time to get the documents together.
Yeah.
And they'll be going straight on to Facebook as soon as I've finished that. But I'm going to print them out and put it on YouTube. I'm going to print out the documents. I'm going to print out that one tomorrow. And I'm going. Oh no, I got the printer here. I can print it out tomorrow. The one that I just finished today, the one I'm telling you about. And then I'll explain it. That's the best way to do it. I'll explain how it fits, so that no Maori will be offended by what I'm saying. And it's not really their fault. It's the Crown's fault. And IWI MAORI, right? Yeah. They're the ones that conjured up all of this bullshit. So I think that today I was doing a post and I put the bullshit meter there, and it all disappeared. Everything I wrote for 4.5 hours this morning disappeared. Went off Facebook, and it was because I think it hit a nerve. It hit a nerve because people are watching now. I think the Crown is watching, and they can't get out of it. They can't get out of it because I've just got too much stuff that's being repeated over and over. And even if they delete it, it'll still pop up somewhere else. So that's our proof, mate. Is the church, and we don't have to worry about fighting against anybody else's whakapapa. Because we're just going with Raki. That's the original name of Mount Taranaki, is Raki. Raki. And it's come, and that map, you'll have a look at it, and on it's got Mount Hikurangi on it, and then beside, the other mountain beside it is called Aoraki. Aoraki, that's the South Island, Cook. It's called Aoraki. That's the other Raki. Right? There's two Rakis. Aoraki and Raki. The real original name Raki and Aoraki came from Chatham Islands with the Manukau.
Oh, okay.
That's where that came from. So I'm telling Aoraki is they flew there. It's got flying through the skies. It's mist. That's what that means.
Yeah.
Something like that. So that's all that history I've got here documented, and from the history from Mohi Manukau, because he had four paramount chiefs. Timati Manukau, the first, second, third. He's the fourth. Back all the way back and Tira Waikato, Whareherehere Manukau, the Ngāpuhi squashed their history and took that history and changed it for their treaty claims. And I did the Y121 treaty claim, and I said to everybody at the hearings, take that name Manukau off your titles, off your treaty claims, take it off. Because they used Manukau as a reference right through the country for their treaty. I said, take that, I'm telling you, I'm in charge of this Manukau Y121 claim. Take that name off your claims.
Yeah.
Don't use that name because it belongs here with me. And so that in the Manukau Harbour, I says, why wasn't it called Kupe Harbour? Why wasn't it called Tainui Harbour or something else Harbour? It's because the British put that name there, Manukau. That's why. Only for that sake. And they shouldn't argue, they should just say, oh, we'll go with it and go and pick the loot up off them. Because all the money they've ever made in Britain has come out of these titles, right through the world. They're using the same native title here in the Te Ture Whenua Act in Australia, 1993 Act. They've stolen that as well. They called it the 1993 Native Act Australia, and they can't tell you where they got it from. That's when I wrote to the governor in Victoria. I says, don't use Queen Victoria for your oath of office, because I'll get you for it. Because that's King William's niece. And they didn't. They swore to the community. That's the Commonwealth of Australia have stolen our contract with Westminster with the 1993 Te Ture Whenua Act is a contract. That's another contract from Westminster. Two contracts, the 1834 flag, the 1835 flag, and that, Te Ture Whenua Act. See? It was there all the time, but I've gone and thrown the Te Ture Whenua right out. I've gone back to King William's Act. They can't stop me from using those acts. And it's got the hanging chains, I can go and hang anybody with the acts. Because it's still a contract. The Admiralty is private. Nobody can inquire into as a third party. That's why I'm saying with these videos I make. There's only two parties, me and the other one I'm accusing. Right? One by one. I take him out, I'm going to knock him out one by one. And that's the only way to do it, is that person's got to stand up in front of me and prove me they have better information than what I've got. Or a better title, All I say is, where'd you get the title from? Right? They'll always end up on King William the Fourth. No matter what. Any title in the world. From Britain. Any title in the world from Britain. So that's how it works, mate. We're looking good anyway. I'm more confident now we're going to be walking on that block of land after the first. of May. And it's really up to all the chiefs who are going to Parihaka. It's really them. The elders are the ones, when they put their hands up and say, all right, that's it. That's it. From that mountain, they'll come to this mountain, and that will put the two mountains together. Then it's the South Island one. Is going to fall in place with these ones because it's on this map. We don't have to go down South Island. It's already on the map. That's why Ngati Porou pinched it. Because the Aoraki's on the map.
Okay.
And they took that down South Island as their title. Now, they got a problem. They got facing these elders at Parihaka. I said, you want the money? You want this pound note to liven up? Do this. Do this, and this pound note will come alive.
Okay.
See? That's how it's done.
Yeah.
That's pretty simple. That's pretty simple.
Yeah.
I've got no problems so far. It's the nine more days. Oh, there's plenty of time to put this. That only gives me 21 days notice for anybody to come up with anything. So I'll be rolling it over and over and over and over in those 21 days online, and that'll do it. Yeah. So we don't have to worry about anybody else.
Yeah.
It's set. I'll send this thing off you in a minute on email.
Okay.
And the picture I've just done today. Well, yeah. It's taken me 2 or 3 days to do, but it's more complete now.
Okay.
And I'll be putting the Manukau's history Whakapapa right online tomorrow. And that'll blow them a bit some more. Once that gets out there and it's bringing the four big main tribes together, and I think it's timely to do it now, so that everybody understands how it fits, and no one's losing anything. They've got everything to gain because these other elite people are starting to fold up now. The EU Parliament is starting to fall apart. And the Queen is trying to run back to England.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's saying she's going back to Britain to support Britain.
Yeah, yeah.
And so Donald Trump's just changed his mind about supporting Britain. He's gone back to the EU. So he's backing the EU now. See, so all the fraud people are getting sifted out. And he's one of them. He's supposed to be a good guy, but he's out to make money.
Yeah.
You see, he's made a lot of money, and he'll make more money if they keep the fraud going.
Oh, okay.
So what I'm doing here will bust him and all his fraud.
Yeah.
Because it's the same Queen that's doing all the damage. And they won't be able to back out of this one.
Yeah.
Because everything is in Waitangi Marae. I've been telling these Maoris, everything's in there that's been hidden.
Yeah.
The native court will fix it up. The native court. The other native people are waiting for us, but they it's still hard to understand.
Yeah.
Unless it's one-on-one or you know, you really go slow and explain everything.
Yeah.
It's just...
Yeah.
No, I've got it sort of sussed out, but it's too many things to go and look at one thing and the other, but now it's starting to... I'm starting to put it together.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I'm starting to pick the bones out of what matters. That will make the biggest impact, and it's that church and those. I put the names of them there as well, on that map.
Yeah.
I put everything there. Okay, I'll get it all out and I'll send it to you, eh?
Yeah, all right, come later.
Okay, Rapata.
Yeah.
Okay, mate, all just right. Keep in touch anyway. I'll tell you any more new developments, but ring me any time you want to, okay?
Yeah, okay, come later.
All right.
Yep.
Yeah. There, that's it. That's a long talk. That's Rapata, Kaa. His family's the Reverend or the Ministers of the Church of England, and our family, the Wanos, are ministers as well, way back to 1831. So that's got a track record or a paper trail right back through England, through the Church of England, 1831. No one's going back that far, and the treaty claims here. The pirates stopped everybody from going past 1840 because they have no fact evidence to go past 1840, because 1837 is when Te Araroa and most of the places on the map of the East Cape shows you who came on the land when. And there's no one at 1831, just the Kaa and the Wanoa and those who know they're with us. Okay, that's all for now. Today is Wednesday, 5th of April 2017. And I'll just carry on going with the work. Jamie, we're getting there. Rapata's got a bit more about it, and I hope you are too online on Facebook and YouTube, Google and Twitter. So, John Wanoa, see you later. Have a good evening.